Ah, good to see you again. Your active help is most welcome. I'm having a tough time keeping up with all the work. Do you know how many people around here are frustrated and thinking of moving away? If things keep going like that, this place could become a ghost town. To make matters worse, the water supply broke down this morning. It seems there's a crack in the pipeline. So if you want to help give people here another chance, let's fix the water line first. Get in your tractor and go to the local building supply store. You'll find it. I'm relieved. Thanks to your quick action replacing that broken piece, the water supply is repaired and back on. Good job. Since we're finished here, maybe you could give me a hand with something else. Old Joe owns a run-down motel on the outskirts of town. I've been promising him for a while that I would do some renovations on the place. Be a good fella and drive the flatbed truck over there. I'll follow behind and tell you what needs to be done. Old Joe wants us to pretty up his forecourt a little. I don't foresee any big problems. Joe's also been after a new sign on the motel roof for a while now, something that travelers can see clearly from the highway. As it happens, there's a hotel in town that's about to be torn down. That sly fox Joe picked up the neon sign letters cheap, and a crane operator on the construction site opposite owes me a favor. Drive by there later to pick up the letters. But first, let's take care of the forecourt. I have a roller ready for you, so get in and start compacting. Old Joe won't believe his eyes. The entryway looks better than when this place opened 30 years ago. You did an excellent job. Even the recycled neon signs are working perfectly. You can finally see the motel from the highway. I'm sure it will start attracting tourists again. Do you have another minute you can spare? Then let's meet at the old gas station in town. Someone else there needs our help. This gas station, owned by Pete and his wife Helena, has been losing money for some time. But now that more tourists are stopping here off the highway, they want us to build a new tank. The old tank is already waiting for you to lift it out of its pit. I also got a backhoe loader for you, so you can refill the pit when the new tank is installed. Then put some concrete on top and you're done. Piece of cake, right?
Thank you.
Pete and Helena bought this property back when the town was flourishing. Most businesses here are family-owned, like this one. It'd be a shame if they had to shut their doors because they're no longer profitable. Of course, things look pretty bleak if no visitors are coming to town. But you know what? Joe and I had a great idea that may sound a little crazy, but we have to give it a shot. Take the broken tank to Joe's motel. Then I'll fill you in over there. See you soon. Perfect timing. The preparations are underway. I'm sure you're wondering what exactly we're up to. Well, it's like this. We need something spectacular to keep this town from going completely under. So we'll work some magic here and special effects there. And presto, we'll have swarms of tourists coming for a peek with their cameras. On the outskirts, there's a place that we already set up for our plan. We just need your help to put the final piece in place. We should be finished by morning. At last. There you are. Now all we have to do is keep our mouths shut and see what happens. But one thing's as certain as the sun rising in the morning. The people in this town love rumors and headlines. Soon everyone will be talking about the glowing object from another world. I'm sure of that. And all thanks to your help. Good job. Listen, to be honest, I'm pretty satisfied with what I've done with my life. My career has been rock solid, but I also think it's high time that I retire. My business is small, but in good shape, and it needs someone to pick up the reins. And I honestly can't think of anyone better for this job than you. So, what do you say? I'd stick around for a while to help until you're on your feet. Deal?